So we're back with another round of studio sessions, and this is the third episode. The first one I talked a little bit more about the bass and the kick. The second episode about how to master a track, and this episode is going to be all about how to build a melody using standard sounds, melody. All right, so we're back in our project. So I've gathered a few sounds. I made them as standard as possible, so everybody pretty much has the same sounds. So what I usually do is I'm gonna make a melody not actually how you would do it when you know how to read notes on the keyboard. So I'm gonna kind of build it using a matrix scheme, so everybody who doesn't know how to play piano can still make a melody. So we're gonna start with like a basic sound. So what I've selected was kind of like a sequencer kind of synth like this. It's a pretty standard synth, pretty much everybody has that. I used the ES2 for that. It's a standard Logic synth. It's a really cool synth, actually. You can make some phenomenal sounds with it. But you know, you can use pretty much every single synth out there for this kind of melody. So this is kind of like an ARP sound. So I'm gonna kind of make a melody that's gonna be very easy in the basis, but still, you know, let's hope it sounds pretty complex in the end. So, for instance, you know, if you use like tones like this, I'm going to start with the A, for instance, like this. So it's like all the keys next to each other. You can still make a very nice melody out of that. So let's start using that. I used the kick we made in the first episodes, and now I'm gonna go to a matrix scheme. A matrix scheme pretty much is the keyboard. You can see over here, but instead of playing the notes, you can actually just draw in your notes yourself. So you can really build it up starting from scratch. So, you know, we're gonna use these notes. So that's the A. So here we go. So let's just use it as standard as possible. So like this, make it a little bit smaller. Okay, so let's take the second note. Okay, third note. And we're gonna use a little bit of a groove here. Gonna put it just before the kick. And on the afterbeat. So now it's pretty simple, and we can also build in a little bit of a variation. Let's use make this a little bit bigger. Yeah, here we go. Okay, so we're gonna copy this to the next bar. Now. Now it's twice as long, so what we can also do is add a little bit more variation by removing the last track and make the second last a little bit longer. Now it sounds like this. Okay, so also if we add some standard delay and some reverb, it already sounds a lot more interesting, so let's play it. Okay, so this already sounds pretty cool. So now we're gonna copy this one more time and kind of make a little bit more variation. Let's copy the kick, there you go. Over here, all right. So now we're back to these notes over here. This is the second part. So we're gonna use four bars and a little bit of a variation towards the end. So this is the third and the fourth bar. And now I'm gonna make it a little bit more interesting. Like for instance like this. All right. Okay, so now if we're gonna use four bars and remove the kick. So yeah, now we have like we're using a very simple kind of way of drawing in the notes. We already have a very interesting melody. So now we're gonna add some bass. So what I've done is I've just made a very, very simple groove bass. Everybody can search that. It's in every standard library. So we're just gonna play this melody over here. And we started with the A note, so you can use the A as start. And then we're gonna use a few other notes to make it a little bit more interesting. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this twice as long. All right, gonna draw in another matrix scheme for the bass line. So it's the A note. So we're gonna use the A as a first note, which is also the first note of our arp melody. And we're gonna draw this in for two bars. And now you can go up or you can go down. So let's go down. And now we already have some more variation. And now for the third. Okay, it's, you know, I'm just doing this all by ear, so if it sounds good, then I'm gonna use it. For instance, we can use this. This is a very simple way of building a bass line. So yeah, this already sounds pretty good. It's a pretty simple way of drawing in the bass line for your melody. It's also a little bit more of a complex way of doing a melody, creating a little bit more life into your you know, a chord scheme. For instance, let's see, we're starting by this, and then we're gonna move to the D. And perhaps then go to the A, and just leave this as it is. So now we have a completely bit different bass melody, using the same melody we made for the sequence. So let's listen to this one. So I actually prefer this bass over the other one. I think that's a little bit more too simple. This is a little bit more complex, and you know, I always love a little bit more complex. So let's see if we can add, yeah, for instance, like a standard violin. So. So I copied the same notes from the bass to the violin section, so that already sounds pretty cool. But now I'm gonna build a chord. Also, I'm gonna do it a little bit more by ear. So I'm gonna copy one note. So this is the original note. So I think this is a pretty natural follow-up. So if we're gonna kind of play it together. So now you already have a standard chord. I think this one will be good over here. So this already sounds pretty cool. So I'm using one note that's four above. This is a fifth. This is actually a third. So you can actually make a good combination out of those. Let's see what we can do with the last one. So we can use it a little bit below. Build some more. I think this is gonna work. So still, you know, I'm just simply doing it by ear. Some will work, others will be a little bit too minor, others will, you know, it will sound a little bit too sad, so you can higher it up. So let's see what happens with this note over here. So that's pretty cool. So perhaps this one over here. So yeah, here you have it. It's a pretty simple chord scheme. I usually only use a layer of three notes. Obviously, you can also use more layers. You can also combine different sounds. So you say like this layer, the top layer, I'm going to use a different sound for that. With some chords, you can actually make them as complex as you want, so you can use seven notes or eight notes on top of each other. But to keep it simple, I'm just going to use three notes, and also I'm going to see if I can build the melody a little bit better in the chords, because it's a little bit too sad in from the second bar. So let's see, I'm going to kind of use the lowest notes the same, and I'm going to remove these. Still, it's a little bit too sad. Let's put this one up. Yeah, that's better. And perhaps. Yeah. Like this. Yeah, so now it's a little bit less sad, so definitely that's what we want for this track. So yeah, this is like a pretty simple chord using a really simple violin. Already it sounds pretty solid. So now we're gonna kind of see if we can make like a top line on top of this one. So I'm gonna use this bar over here. Also, I used a very simple ES2 synth, Brightest Fuzz. So this is. So this is the sounds. Also using a little bit of verb and delay, and also used a side kick to duck the kick a little bit for using the melody. Creates a little bit more life for the top line. So let's see. Okay, so cool. Yeah, we're gonna now draw in a top layer using the Brightest Fuzz sound from the ES2. So let's just play this one. So the bass starts at A, so let's use this one as a C. Okay. So let's create a melody that actually keeps on evolving throughout the scheme, perhaps even using 16 bars instead of 8. So we're just gonna very simply copy these and make sure it's gonna go up and up and up to make the melody pretty uplifting. So let's give it a try. This one over here. Perhaps. Okay. That's pretty cool. You can also, if you only want to use 8 bars, You can copy it back, so then you have the natural, you know, evolution throughout the melody. So then it sounds like this. So then you make it 8 bars. You can also make it 16 bars, or 32 actually, if you want to. Just to evolve the melody throughout the track. So let's just put this one over here. And still, you know, I'm just doing everything by ear. So let's copy this all together to make it 16 bars. All right. I'm gonna join these two sections. So we have perhaps then use this one as a first tone. Okay. So the great thing about, you know, building the melody as it is right now is you can actually go up and up and up and up. So throughout your whole arrangements, you have a melody that actually changes throughout the course of the track. So you can also use it just for 16 bars, and then you have a pretty standard length of a melody. Actually, this is already quite long, but I think it sounds pretty solid. Also, we're just gonna copy the bass to one track below, and basically, let's see, this is just a very simple sinus, and I'm gonna copy this one octave down. So yeah, now it's pretty low, and I think, you know, if now we're gonna play all the melodies we made all together as one arrangement, it's gonna sound like this. So by opening the color filter, you're actually releasing the sound. The solo. You can also just put the whole thing one octave up, and then you have a very high melody. You can add a little bit more verb to it. This is also like a very standard verb. Perhaps a little bit more delay. Make the length of the delay, the feedback, a little bit longer. And now, and it's gonna start more, a little bit more to sound like a lead. And altogether, it's. Down. That's two chords. Here we go. So, you know, that's basically how you can build a melody. You can play around with the function of your synth, or you know, the feedback of your delay, the mix output, you know, to make it as dry and wet as possible. So basically what I've done is I've used very, very standard sounds. You can also use, you know, other sounds by using synths like Massive, C-Length, Serum, you know, Nexus. For the, you know, the fans of hardware, I can definitely recommend the Virus C. Virus C is a really cool synth that sounds a pretty analog, although it's not actually an analog synth, it's a digital synth. It's a perfect synth to use for really strong, you know, fat sounding synths and lead sounds. Besides that, I use the Moog Voyager a lot for my bass lines, or just, you know, like I've showed in the first episode, the Spectrasonics Trillion plugin. So yeah, today we talked about melody, how to build a melody, how to use certain sounds, and how to use different layers in a track. And the next episode, I'm gonna talk a little bit more about how to arrange a track. You know, there's all sorts of arrangements, some work better than the other for certain styles of tracks. So I'm gonna show you a few tricks on how to arrange a track. And also I'm gonna talk a little bit more about when you're building your own you know, little studio, what to take in consideration with speakers, and also, you know, how to adjust the sound in your studio to make sure that, you know, the sound is the best possible you can have it for producing a track. And also, you know, if people have questions, they can send it in at social@centervandoorn.com. And in the final episode, I'm gonna treat as many questions as possible. So see you guys next time.